नमस्ते, टुडे वील बी डीलिंग अबाउट वस्तुकल्पना। मूविंग ऑन टू द इंट्रोडक्शन, ट्रीटमेंट इन जनरल मे बी ब्रॉडली क्लासिफाइड इनटू टू कैटेगरीज, दैट इज शमन चिकित्सा एंड शोधन चिकित्सा, डिपेंडिंग ऑन वेदर द विशिएटेड दोषास आर पैसिफाइड इन द बॉडी, दैट इज इन शमन, और दे आर एलिमिनेटेड इन केस ऑफ शोधन। So, Shamana Chikilsa includes Deva Vyapasraya Chikilsa and Yuddhi Vyapasraya Chikilsa and Sattva Vijaya Chikilsa. Whereas, Shodhana Chikilsa includes Vamana, Virejana, Vasti. Vasti is one among the Shodhana Chikilsa and it is more beneficial in diseases condition of Vata Dosha. Moving on to the definition, Vastina Diyade Idi Vastihi. That is, Vasti term is derived from the root word vas, which means vasati or vasa, that is to stay in one place. Since the urine is collected in urinary bladder, it is called as vasti. Called as vasti chikilsa, since the urinary bladder was used to administer aushadha dravya through rectum with the intention of correcting vishiated dosha. Chikilsa is considered as a complete and superior treatment. It is mainly preferred for diseases of Vata Dosha predominance. Nevertheless, it is equally useful in diseases of Pitta Dosha, Kapha Dosha, Rakta Dosha and other conditions. Vata is the only dosha with motility and it is considered as the vehicle for other doshas and is responsible for transfer of diseases from one place to other. So the treatment, that is Vasta Chikilsa, will take care of predominant causative factor is when Vata, the predominant causative factor is said to be the superior treatment. Hence, administration of drugs or medicaments through rectum with the help of Vasti Indra is called as Vasti Karma. The preparation of medicaments used for Vasti Karma are considered under Vasti Kalpas. In olden days, the apparatus used for Vasti Karma was generally made out of animal bladder, as I have mentioned. Hence, this term is invoked even. Moving on to the classification, Vasti has been classified into different types by different authors. Based on Adhishthana, it is classified into Pakvashaya Gadha Vasti, Mutrashaya Gadha Vasti and Garbhashaya Gadha Vasti, and based on Dravya, it is classified into Niruha and Anvasana. Based on Sankhya, it is classified into Karma Vasti, Kala Vasti and Yoga Vasti, and based on miscellaneous classification, Amrado, Prasrada Yogika, Rakta, Vaitarana, Kshara and Kshira. So Dravya Beda, as I have mentioned, it is mainly classified into Niruha Vasti and Anuvasana Vasti. Astavana Vasti is also called as Niruha Vasti, Shodhana Vasti and Kashaya Vasti. Anuvasana Vasti is called as Sneha Vasti as well as Shamana Vasti. As Vastis sustain the body by eliminating vitiated doshas, they are called as Niruha Vasti. They nourish this body and prolong the lifespan, so they are also called as Astavana Vasti. So, classification on the basis of route of administration of drug is also there, that is Gudagada Vasti includes both Anvasana and Asthavana, and Uttara Vasti, that is Garbhashegada and Mutrashegada, Vranagada Vasti, that is administration of drug into deep-rooted wounds. Again, classification based on Sankhya is given as Karma Vasti, Kala Vasti and Yoga Vasti. So, in Karma Vasti, 18 Sneha Vastis and 12 Niruha Vastis are given. In Karma Vasti, 18 Sneha Vasti and 12 Niruha Vasti is given, totaling it up to 30. And in case of Kala Vasti, Vastis and 6 Niruha Vastis is given, totaling it up to 16. And in case of Yoga Vasti, 5 Sneha Vasti and 3 Niruha Vasti is given, adding it up to a number of 8. Again, classification according to nomenclature is also given, such as Yavana Vasti, Siddha Vasti, Prasrada Yogika Vasti, Dwadasha Prasradi Vasti, पादहीनमस्ति, तीक्ष्णमस्ति, मृदुमस्ति, पिच अस्ति, रक्तमस्ति, एक्सेट्रा. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू एक्शन सुश्रुताचार्य हैज क्लासिफाइड इट इनटू शोधनमस्ति, लेखनमस्ति, ब्रह्मणमस्ति. Whereas Vagbhattacharya has mentioned it into Utkleshanavasti, Dosharavasti and Shamanavasti. As per Acharya Sharangadhara, it is classified into Utkleshanavasti, Shodhanavasti, Shamanavasti and Dosharavasti. And as per Acharya Charaka, it is classified into Vatagnavasti, Pitagnavasti, Kafagnavasti, Rektagnavasti, Pichavasti and Sangrahivasti. So the main indications of Vasti are as: it is mainly indicated in sarvanga roga, ekanga roga, kukshi roga, vata sanga, mutra mala shukra sanga, jwara, pakshagada, upadamsha, mutra krishra, mudagarbha, unmada, shirutshula, parshan prishtashula, katishula, akshepaga, svikshula, janu, janga, uru shula, yoni shula, arshas, ashmari, udavarta. And it is contraindicated in cases of ajirna, alasaga, kshudrartha, kshudartha, vamana virechana krit, krudanasya karma, visujiga, madumeha, pandu, kushta, thaulyan. So basti netra and basti putaga together constitutes basti yantra. Hence, it's an instrument used for administration of aushadha dravya into the rectum. Basti netra. In olden days, mala were used as vasti netra. They were also prepared from wood, gold, silver, bronze, etc. metals. And the shape and structure of the netra to be used are, it should be having three karnikas, that is 1, 2, 3. And the length of vasti netra will be discussed later. Vastiputaka should be oval in shape, that is Trikona Gola, and it should be solid. So the measurement of Vasti Netra depending upon the age group is as: up to 6 years it should be 6 angula, that is approximately 4 inches, increase 1 by 3rd angula per year. And for 12 years, it should be 8 angula, that which is approximately 6 inches, increase angula per year. And for 20 years and above, it is 12 angula, which is approximately 9 inches. And as I have mentioned, for 6 to 12 years, we should be increasing 1 by 3rd angula per year. For 12 to 20 years, we should be increasing 1 by 2 angula per year. So, in case of Uttaravasti, Netra should be 12 and 14 angula. Pranavasti Netra is considered as 18 angula. So, Acharya has also mentioned 8 Vasti Netra doshas, that is Hrasvada, Dirgada, Tanuta, Sthula, Jirnada, Shitala Bandhanata, Parshuchitra, Vakrata. So, Vasti Putta. It is made of bladder of animals like Mahisha or Harini. It should be oval in shape. It should be free from holes. It should be free from dirty smell. It should be smooth and it should be free from germs. And Basti Putaka doshas are, they are also Vishamata, Mamsala, Chidrayukta, Sthula, Snigda, Klinada. So sneha vas matra in case of vasti dravya is in for vataja diseases 1/4 of kada should be taken, for pittaja diseases 1/6 of kada should be taken, for kaphaja diseases 1/8 of kada should be taken, and for a healthy individual 1/6 of kada should be taken, and for tridosha 1/5 part of kada should be taken. So moving on to the method of administration, it is mainly classified into Purva Karma, Pradhana Karma and Paschata Karma. So in Purva Karma, we should be doing the Dosha Vijara, Aushadha Vijara, Desha Vijara, Karya, Sattva Vijara, Oka Vijara, Vaya Vijara and Bala Vijara. In Purva Karma, It mainly includes steps such as selection of patient based on these principles, and then Abhyanga and Swedana should be given, Basti Dravya Pramana Nirdharana and Basti Dravya Mishrana should be done. So moving on to the Basti Dravya Mishrana, the Dravya are to be mixed in specific order to obtain the perfect mixture. Madhu, Saindava Lavana, Sneha Dravya, Kalka Dravya and Kwada are to be mixed in order as mentioned by Charaka, that is Makshigam, Lavanam, Sneham, Kalkam, Kwada, Midi, Kramad. The Sneha and the Kwada are immiscible liquid, so they are, as they are oil and water, but the other ingredients here emulsifying agent to mix both and prepare an emulsion at the end and by stirring continuously with the khaja. Moving on to Pradhana Karma, it includes Basti Pranidhana, Basti Pratyagamana, Nirikshan of Yoga and Adiyoga Lakshana. So the general Basti procedure is, the time of Basti administration is Jirna Anna Kala, that is in the morning, and first we have to make the patient lie down in left with his left leg extended and right leg fully flexed, and apply oil in the Basti Netra and anal region for lubrication. Keep Basti Dravya warm to match the body temperature. Then Sadravya Basti Yantra Netra is slowly and steadily inserted up to third knob into the Guda. Putaka is held once and liquid is pushed with even pressure. Avoid pushing all the liquid to prevent chances of air entry, and ask the patient to breathe in as the liquid is pushed. Remove out the netra slowly. Let the patient to be in the same position for a while. Later, he may shift to supine position and wait for urges. Let him get up and pass when urges come. If bedridden, bedpan is to be provided. So, Basti Pranidhana has been explained. So, some of the precautions which has to be taken are, patient should take deep inspiration while administration. Netra insert should be inserted up to 4 to 6 inches, and some dravya should be left in the puttaka. After administration, patient should lie down for 30 matra kala. So, Basti Pratyagamana and Nirikshana. In case of Niruha Basti, one muhurta is the Pratyagamana kala for Niruha Basti. It is the Paramakala, and measures are to be taken to bring it out if it does not come out in that stipulated time period. Specified time, then it may cause complications like Atmana, Pakvasheshula, Vada Pradilomada, Hrud Pradesha Pida, Jwara, Arati, etc. So measures to be followed while Niruha Basti Dravya does not come out are administration of another Tikshna Basti, Phalavarti administration, Ushnadrava Sveda, Ovasroni, Uruswik and Pakvashaya, Oshasana, Uttrasana and Videshana Dravya administration. In case of Anuvasana Basti, Pratyagamana Kala is 3 Yama, that is 9 hour is the Pratyagamana Kala specified for Anuvasana Basti. However, the liquid should not come out before 9 hours as we want it to remain inside for at least 9 hours. In case the liquid returns within 9 hours, another Basti should be administered. Reasons for early return of the Basti Dravya might be the administration in larger quantity or incomplete evacuation of bowels before Basti. If Basti Dravya does not come out even after 9 hours, then one has to wait up to 24 hours and later think of other measures as suggested in Niruha Basti. Some authors advise to ignore the delay of Anuvasana Basti Pratyagamana even after 24 hours if no complications appear in the person. After Basti Dravya Pratyagamana, the patient is asked to take normal food by next day noon. In case of failure, Pakvasheshula, Advana, Motrashula, Vishtamba, Shula, Aradi, etc. will happen. So, treatment is by administration of Tikshna Basti containing Gomotra, Yavakshara, Tikshna Amla Dravyas, introduction of Phalavarti, Swedan of Shoni, Kati, Vankshana Pradesha, and Virechana with Erenda Sneha, Atrivrit Churna, Lehya, Trifala Churna, etc. So some of the Samyak Yoga Lakshanas are Prasrada Vit, Prasrishta Vit, Mutra, Pitta, Kapha, Vayu, which gets moved gradually, and Laghutva, Laghuda in Pakvashaya, Agni Tikshnada, Roga Shamana Lakshana, increase in Bala, and Ayoga Lakshanas are pain in the head, heart and lungs region, etc. Shodha, Hrillasa, Vitsanga, Mutra Sanga, Shwasa Krishra, Parikartika and Guruda. And Adi Yoga Lakshanas are Anga Supti, Anga Marda, Korbalya, Unmada, Hikka. And the Paschata Karma includes Vasti Uttara Vijara, Patyadikrama, Vishrama, Sukosha Srana, Administration of Dugda, Yusha and Parihara Kala. So the Vasti Vyapat are mainly classified into Vasti Netra Vyapat, Vasti and then Vasti Data Vyapat. So Vasti Netra Dosha has been mentioned earlier, that is Hraswada, Dirgada, Tanuta, Stulada, Jirnata, Shitilata, Chidrada and Vakrata. And Vasti Putaka Vyapat has also been mentioned, that is Vishamadda, Mamsala, Chidrayukta, Stulada, Sirajalata, Vada Yuktada, Snigdada, Klinnada. And Vasti Data Dosha is also mentioned, that is Drodha Vastidana, Tiryak Pranidana, Ulupta Data Vasti, that is Ulupta means taken away or drawn away. Tensa Kamba Vastidana, Adi Pravrusta Pravishta Netra Vasti, Adi Vega Data Vasti. So, according to Ajari Kashyapa, both Astapana and Vastra Vasti act in Pakvashya and keep Vata in Samavastha, causes Chedana of Vata, destroy all diseases, just like a tree which is cut by roots. Regarding Anuvasana, how watering a plant helps to grow into a tree with flowers, same way there will be an effect on body and it acts on Rasadi Saptadhatus. So according to Acharya Chakrabani, Vasti Dravya reaches entire Srotas and produces elevating action, and Shodhana of the doshas happens from Pada to Shiras. Some of the research which has been carried out researches are, one is by Dr. B. Basavarajeshwari, and the topic was a clinico-pharmacological study to evaluate the efficacy of Madhu Tailika Vasti in Parkinson's disease. And another research work is comparative pharmaceutical analytical study of formulation of Madhu Tailika Vasti prepared by classical and modified method. So, I would like to conclude by saying that Vasti is indeed considered under Ardha Chikitsa. And here, what has to be given importance is regarding the mixing methodology. So it can also be compared to rectal transmucosal administration of drug, where rectal administration provides rapid absorption of many drugs. However, rectal administration of drugs should be avoided in immunosuppressed patients in whom even minimal trauma could lead to formation of an abscess, and the rate of rectal transmucosal absorption is affected by the following factors, that is formulation, volume of liquid, concentration of catheter, presence of stool in the rectal wall, pH of rectal contents, rectal retention of drugs administered, differences in venous drainage within the rectosigmoid region. So the drugs administered high in the rectum, that is drained by the superior rectal veins, are usually carried directly to the liver and thus they are subjected to metabolism. Drugs administered low in the rectum are delivered systematically by the inferior and middle rectal veins before passing through the liver. Problems may occur with drugs that normally have a high hepatic extraction ratio. The clinical importance of rectal venous drugs are not well defined even in the most advanced and update books. The most important consideration are slow onset of effects and prolonged duration of effect. The peak blood level vary considerably from patient. However, more light is required on the absorption and bioavailability of Vasti Dravya administered. It can also be compared to the procedure of enema, which is generally defined as a rectal injection for cleaning the bowel or for administering the drug or the food. So enema is a procedure by which a medicated solution is introduced into the rectum with the intention of cleansing or for therapeutic benefits. Enema solutions may be oily or aqueous. They may be suspensions also. They are generally administered into the rectum mainly for their purgative and anti-helminthic action. So these are enemas given for nutritive effects also. All the enemas are heated to body temperature before administering to prevent stimulation of intestinal peristalsis. Commonly used drugs in enema are sodium bicarbonate 2%, sodium phosphate, magnesium sulfate, sodium soap or glycerin, and other drugs include olive oil, turpentine, tannic acid, barium sulfate, etc. So, mechanism of action of Vasti Chikitsa is as, among the measures adopted in the management of Vata Vyadhis, Anuvasana and Asthavana Vastis are considered to be supreme devices because they can act locally as well as systematically. Like the roots to a plant, Pakvashya is the root for Vata. Destruction of the stem, flower, fruits is caused by uprooting the tree. Likewise, even the disease of other parts of the body caused by vitiated Vata can be relieved by treating it at level of its root, that is Pakvashya, with the help of Vasti. Charaka as well as Sushruta got another similar example to explain the mechanism of action of Vasti. The water and the fertilizers poured at the root of a plant will reach all other parts and help them grow well and give out flowers and fruits. In the same way, drugs administered through rectum reach all parts of the body and exhibit their action. The reference is in Charaka Siddhisthana, 1st chapter, 31st sloka, Chakravani Tikha. So according to modern science opines that the drugs administered in the form of systemically. The rectum has a rich blood and lymph supply. So the drugs administered through it gets absorbed into the superior hemorrhoidal vein and from the upper part of rectal mucosa. From there, it enters the portal vein and thus enters the systemic circulation and acts accordingly. So, drugs through rectal route, as per modern science, it's mainly enema and suppositories are the two dosage forms used for introduction into the rectum. So, enemas are the aqueous or oily solutions or suspensions intended for introduction into the rectum for the purgative, sedative, anti-helminthic and anti-inflammatory or nutritive effect. They may also be used for X-ray examination of the lower bowel. And generally, this solutions in the volume of 500 ml to 1 liter, depending on the age and condition of the patient, is introduced as enema. However, the commercially available concentrated enemas are introduced in small volumes. Large volume enemas should be warmed to body temperature before administration, as I have mentioned earlier. Second one is suppositories. Suppositories are used to produce local action and to produce systemic action, to produce mechanical action on the lower bowel and to facilitate evacuation in the treatment of hemorrhoids, anal irritation, constipation, etc. They can be easily administered to children, older person and to unconscious person who cannot swallow the drugs easily. The rectal suppositories are used for lubricating, soothing, antiseptic, local anesthetic action or for astringent effect. So therefore, they may contain antiseptics, local anesthetics, astringent, hormones, and the rectal suppositories meant for systemic effect contains analgesics, antispasmodics, sedatives and tranquilizers. The lower portion of the rectal area from which the soluble substance can pass quickly and reach the venous circulation directly and rapid action of the drug is produced. However, the rate and extent of absorption depends upon the nature of base in which they have been incorporated. The maximum therapeutic effect is produced if the drug incorporated is in finely divided state, evenly distributed throughout the base and in readily absorbable form. The rectal suppositories are extensively used as a mechanism to produce its action by irritating the mucous membrane of the rectum or by lubricating action. The glycerin suppositories are a representative example of evacuant suppositories. Thank you for listening.